broadcasting live from WOUB TV in Athens. This is Newswatch.
One local couple is proving how their love trumps hate. Good evening, I'm Abby Grisey.
And I'm Justin Holbrock. Thanks for joining us. One Athens couple tied the knot just hours after Donald Trump was elected last night. Lauren Marsan and Jolena Hansberger got married after fears that the right to same-sex marriage may be reversed during a Trump presidency. A friend officiated the wedding, and to make the ceremony even more special, their dog served as the ring bearer.
Dr. Marsan and her partner, they just got this together so fast, and so many people showed out, and I think the support that was here just shows how, like, this community is involved and, like, how they actually care about the people here. So despite everything that's going on, I think this has been the silver lining today.
About 40 to 50 people watched the couple wed on the Athens County Courthouse steps.
Republican Jay Edwards will soon be taking his seat in Columbus as the 94th District Representative. Edwards won 58% to 42% in the race against Democrat Sarah Grace, according to unofficial election results. Edwards made an appearance at the Athens County Republican headquarters to celebrate his victory last night. He says he plans to work across party lines to get the Appalachian caucus back together and try to solve issues like the drug epidemic.
I had a message throughout my whole campaign of bipartisanship, putting down party lines, enough of the bickering back and forth, and we need someone that's actually going to be effective and work for the people of southeastern Ohio. And I think that the voters spoke, and that's what they wanted.
Edwards says he is humbled to have won and is ready to get to work.
Last night, we were live on Facebook at Pigskin for the local Democrat watch party. OU Dems, Students for Hillary, and 94th District State Representative candidate Sarah Grace gathered together as the results came in. But last night did not go how Democrats were hoping, both locally and nationally following Clinton's defeat and Grace's loss. Vice President of OU Dems, Anthony Eliopoulos, says he's disappointed Edwards will be representing the 94th District.
It definitely hurts. We worked super hard to get her elected. I think she would have been a great voice for the city of Athens and the 94th District, but I really hope that Jay works hard, as I know Sarah would have.
Despite the loss, Grace is looking forward to going back to her normal life as a mother, wife, and local business owner. And on the national side, Pigskin had support from Ohio Together campaign. In addition to Students for Hillary and OU Dems, Maggie Yee is a fellow working on the campus side of the Ohio Together campaign and spoke to us when the race for Ohio was too close to call.
They're going a little bit differently than we anticipated. Ohio's turning out a little bit more red than we expected, but you know, we did our job, we did our part, and at the end of the day, everybody from Ohio is going to be represented by who they voted for. So we did all that we could, and I'm happy that everyone who came out to vote did their duty.
Yee was one of the supporters who stayed at Pigskin, hoping Clinton still had a chance after Trump won Ohio and many other swing states.
A small watch party at the Cider House last night started off in high spirits until results started rolling in. Those gathering at the Cider House were willing to share who they were supporting and their opinions until Donald Trump started gaining electoral votes. People grew angry and told us what would happen if Trump were to be elected.
If what's his name, the idiot, is elected, he's going to ruin not only this country, but there's going to be a global depression because he's going to ruin the world.
By the end of the night, the Cider House was quiet as people finished watching the results come in.
Athens residents experienced a power outage off campus today. Stimson Street, Mill Street, Palmer Street, River Park, and one side of Core Street lost power. It lasted for about 2 hours from 11:30 to 1:30. American Electric Power did not know the cause of the outage when we contacted them at 4:30. Casa Nueva had to shut part of their restaurant down and could only serve beverages.
We had to shut down our main restaurant, and of course that affected our lunch sales.
Casa also had to shut down their bodega section during the outage and can only serve beverages. The restaurant was able to reopen during their regular hours at 5 o'clock.
Well, it was a bit of a dreary day out there. We had rain showers throughout the day, overcast skies, but it does look like that is starting to clear up as we head into our evening hours. Good evening and welcome to the Newswatch Weather Center. I'm Allison Gens. Right now in Athens, it's 46 degrees. Those overcast skies are still sticking around. We do have calm winds out there, though, and then looking around the region, temperatures are dropping as we head into our evening hours. 46 degrees in Columbus, 45 in Cambridge, 46 in New Lexington, and 46 as well in Marietta. And looking overnight tonight, you can see that the rain has moved out of our region, but we're still going to see some of those clouds until we head into our early morning hours. So at 41 at 9 p.m., then dropping to 38 by midnight, and then by 3 a.m., 36 degrees. Those skies beginning to clear up a little bit. We'll start to see partly cloudy skies into our early morning hours, and then we'll start even might see some sun for tomorrow, but some cooler temperatures still in store. I'll tell you a little bit more about that in my extended forecast coming up later in the show.
It was a good night for Republicans last night. Republican Frank Hoagland won the Ohio Senate race against incumbent Lou Gentile. The small business owner and former Navy SEAL won the 30th district seat with 53% of the vote. Gentile has served as state senator since 2011.
Alexander local schools will have to wait at least another year before receiving financial help for the district. The 1.5% income tax levy did not pass on the ballots yesterday. The levy was spread between three counties that made up the Alexander School District, Meigs, Alexander, and Athens. They voted against the levy, which only applied to those who live in the district and are working.
Even if you don't have children that go to Alexander, you know someone that does, or you know someone that works there.
We're actually getting less revenue from the state to operate than we were in 2008.
Well, I want to study how they spent their money a little bit, and some of the things I've seen them do, I haven't quite approved of.
Now, this was an operating levy to keep things running as usual, but that didn't pass, and the school board is expecting to make cuts to faculty and transportation.
Washington County police will soon be able to find citizens much faster. As it stands now, if someone calls 911, there is a chance that the signal could be sent over a river to a neighboring county before the correct dispatcher can send help their way. The 0.35 mil levy passed 57% to 43. Lieutenant Pat Gurdy says that in some cases, the old system could take up to 30 minutes to find the caller.
We've spent considerable amount of time searching for people when all we know is a tower location and maybe a distance from the tower, which we've had them as far as 17,000 feet, which is a long way. So what the new system will give us, though, is that exact GPS location will get us within 5 feet.
The new system will also support text and video calling. It will cost taxpayers around $12 a year.
The city of Logan has passed an ordinance to further decriminalize marijuana with a 58% approval rating. So what does that mean since it passed? If you have less than 200 grams of marijuana in Logan, there will be no penalties, including no fines and no jail time. But there is a catch. Logan city officials could decide to charge those caught with marijuana in the city under the Ohio Revised Code. That means people would face the penalties set by the state instead of the zero penalties laid out by the ordinance. Southeast Ohio Normal President Don Keeney explains how the organization will operate moving forward.
Just keep going as normal until it's total freedom. You know, they need to regulate it like alcohol, tobacco. You know, they can put it in a store and sell it out like that. You know, until it's there, I feel there's no reason to stop.
Advocates for Normal, the organization that brought the ordinance forward, have said they will take legal action if the city does not recognize the passage of the issue.
And looking around the globe, some world leaders aren't pleased with Trump's win. That story is coming up.
Plus, Republicans have made a three-way sweep of the presidency, the House and the Senate. How people from both parties are pledging to work together after last night's results. These stories and more when Newswatch returns.
University students really have a huge sense of pride in our campus, in our school, and in our education.
People don't come to Ohio just to go to college. They come here to become a Bobcat.
It's a really unique atmosphere.
Bobcat pride is having that natural camaraderie.
Bobcats are just happy to be Bobcats.
My favorite time of year at Ohio has to be homecoming.
When the alumni come back, you can see that the love of this university doesn't fade.
Once you're a Bobcat, you're always a Bobcat.
Friday nights are all about high school football, but when the games are over and the helmets come off, it's time for some gridiron glory. I'm your host, Danny Dean, back under center. Don't miss a play this season. Join myself and the rest of our team on Friday nights at 11:30 on WOUB. and catch us again on Saturday mornings at 11:30. We are committed to bringing you the stories of players, coaches, and communities. And of course, we can't forget about some highlights. We all know there's nothing better than Friday nights and Gridiron Glory. I knew that I wanted to come to Ohio University from the very first time I visited here.
There's something about the campus that grabs you.
It was really comforting.
Very welcoming.
It's one thing to write down your name and your GPA and that kind of stuff and send it in. It's another thing entirely to be here and see how great it is.
The campus here is just electric.
Absolutely gorgeous. Everything just looked really college-like.
I looked at my mom and I said, this is it. And she said, the tour's just started. I said, no, you don't understand. This is it.
My professors really care. They care about my grades, they care about my opportunities, they care about my experiences, they want me to succeed.
They give those opportunities to the students.
My professors have been extremely approachable.
Literally, their door is always open.
You can go to them with pretty much anything.
Everyone knows your first and your last name and where you sit in the classroom.
I really never feel like I'm being talked down to or just being taught material. I always feel like I'm having a conversation.
And they want to share those opportunities and those experiences with us.
After a divisive and deeply personal campaign, the voters have spoken. Donald Trump is the president-elect, pulling off a stunning victory against Hillary Clinton. Today, people from both parties spoke about putting aside their differences and pledged to work together. Mary Maloney reports.
This is not the outcome we wanted or we worked so hard for, and I'm sorry that we did not win this election for the values we share and the vision we hold for our country.
With tears in her eyes and surrounded by supporters, Hillary Clinton publicly conceded the election.
This loss hurts, but please never stop believing that fighting for what's right is worth it.
One by one, Republicans congratulated their nominee for winning the White House. Former President George H.W. Bush tweeting, "Barbara and I congratulate Donald Trump. Wish him well as he guides America forward as our next president. His family is in our prayers." While celebrating his win, Trump set a different tone than the rhetoric he used during his campaign. Instead of conflict, Trump says he wants peace.
It is time for us to come together as one united people.
That sentiment echoed by President Obama, who says he looks forward to a peaceful transition from an Obama presidency to a Trump presidency.
Everybody is sad when their side loses an election. But the day after, we have to remember that we're actually all on one team.
I'm Mary Maloney reporting.
And the surprise of Trump's big win isn't staying in the country. Former Mexican President Vicente Fox said today he was shocked by the news of Trump's election win. He also said his country would never pay for Trump's proposed wall on the U.S.-Mexico border to keep out illegal immigrants.
What we have to do is deal with him now and deal with the trading issue and the wall issue. Of course, Mexico will never pay for that wall.
And our northern neighbors could be seeing some new faces. The Canadian government's immigration website crashed last night, and experts believe the U.S. election played a major role. Business Insider reports the site went down around 10:30 p.m. Eastern Time, and access has been spotty since. Online searches regarding moving to Canada and becoming a Canadian citizen grew in recent months, particularly after Donald Trump won the Republican presidential nomination.
Despite Dow futures plunging more than 800 points last night, the U.S. stock market seems stable as of today. Stocks sold rapidly due to the uncertainty surrounding a Trump presidency. However, Trump's unexpected ascension to the White House is sending world markets plummeting. Japan's main index lost more than 5% of its value, along with Mexico and China both losing fewer than 2 points each. Stocks in Europe all opened sharply lower, but have since come back. Shares in the UK are up nearly 1%. Despite that drastic drop last night, the Dow has closed today, jumping over 250 points. Here's a look at stocks of local interest.
North Carolina's recent raging wildfires seen from new heights. That story's still ahead.
Sunny skies are on the way, but so is a drop in temperatures. I'll tell you what you can expect in the days ahead next on Newswatch.
Professors really care. They care about my grades, they care about my opportunities, they care about my experiences, they want me to succeed.
They give those opportunities to the students.
My professors have been extremely approachable.
Literally, their door is always open.
You can go to them with pretty much anything.
Everyone knows your first and your last name and where you sit in the classroom.
I really never feel like I'm being talked down to or just being taught material. I always feel like I'm having a conversation.
And they want to share those opportunities and those experiences with us.
Ohio University students really have a huge sense of pride in our campus, in our school, and in our education.
People don't come to Ohio just to go to college. They come here to become a Bobcat.
It's a really unique atmosphere.
Bobcat pride is having that natural camaraderie.
Bobcats are just happy to be Bobcats.
My favorite time of year at Ohio has to be homecoming.
When the alumni come back, you can see that the love of this university doesn't fade.
Once you're a Bobcat, you're always a Bobcat.
I knew that I wanted to come to Ohio University from the very first time I visited here.
There's something about the campus that grabs you.
It was really comforting.
Very welcoming.
It's one thing to write down your name and your GPA and that kind of stuff and send it in. It's another thing entirely to be here and see how great it is.
The campus here is just electric.
Absolutely gorgeous. Everything just looked really college-like.
I looked at my mom and I said, "This is it." And she said, "The tour's just started." I said, "No, you don't understand. This is it."
Friday nights are all about high school football, but when the games are over and the helmets come off, it's time for some gridiron glory. I'm your host, Danny Dean, back under center. Don't miss a play this season. Join myself and the rest of our team on Friday nights at 11:30 on WOUB, and catch us again on Saturday mornings at 11:30. We are committed to bringing you the stories of players, coaches, and communities, and of course, we can't forget about some highlights. We all know there's nothing better than Friday nights and gridiron glory.
Good evening and welcome back to the Newswatch Weather Center. I'm Allison Gens. Right now in Athens, it's 46 degrees. We have those overcast skies out there, but those are looking to clear up as we head into our overnight hours. Our winds are calm and our dew points, or our humidity is at 76 degrees from, or excuse me, percent from those rain showers that moved in today. Now, are looking at our temperatures around the region right now, 46 in Marietta, 45 in Cambridge, 46 in New Lexington, and 46 as well in Ripley. Our almanac is showing we were actually a little bit cooler than our normal temperature for today. Our normal is around 58 degrees. We were at 53 degrees as our high temperature. Our low was 48 degrees, so that was actually 10 degrees warmer than our normal temperature for today. But we did not quite hit that record from 1975 of 79 degrees. Would sure be nice to have some of that warmer weather a little bit back in here, especially as we have a cool down coming up as we head into our weekend. Now, tonight we can see that there's this low pressure system that was over our region. That's what brought us those cloudy skies, that rain today. That has moved its way out off the East Coast, and high pressure is beginning to work its way in. That's going to clear up our skies overnight tonight and throughout the next week. But if you look into tomorrow, the high pressure will be over our region, but then low pressure will begin to push its way in and within the next few days, bringing us some of those cooler temperatures into our region. Now, overnight tonight, temperatures dropping into the low 30s. We have 33 in Newark, 33 in New Lexington as well, 34 in Chillicothe, and 36 in Ironton, with decreasing clouds across the region overnight tonight. Now, tomorrow, warming up a little bit, we have 60 degrees in Columbus, 59 in Newark and New Lexington, 60 in Jackson, a little warmer in Ironton, 63 degrees, mostly sunny skies throughout the day. So it is going to be a nice, pleasant day out there, nice seasonable temperatures for our time of year right now. So get out there and enjoy that day before some of our colder temperatures begin moving their way in. Now, overnight tonight in Athens, 34 degrees for our low temperature with decreasing clouds, but calm conditions because those rain showers are moving their way out. Have moved their way out and those skies will begin to clear. But then tomorrow morning at the bus stop, 35 degrees. It's going to be a chilly morning. No precipitation to worry about, but make sure that you have that jacket for your kids. They have maybe a hat as well because it will be a little bit cold as they're waiting for that bus to pull in and pick them up to take them to school. Now, but by our afternoon, warming up to 59 degrees here in Athens with sunny skies, a nice seasonable day tomorrow, winds southwest 5 to 10 miles per hour. Now your extended forecast here, we can see where those temperatures are beginning to drop. So with Thursday, 59 degrees, but then 57 by Friday. And then if you look Friday night, our first time seeing temperatures dip below freezing with 31 degrees for our low. So keep an eye out for some frost overnight. And that's also moving into Saturday with 50 degrees as our high temperature, very chilly. And then 28 degrees for our Saturday night. That's going to be the coldest we've felt this year, and so start to see those temperatures drop, but they do go back up for next week. Now send it over to Abby.
Thanks, Allison. You're looking at wildfires raging in North Carolina from space. A sensor flying aboard a NASA and NOAA spacecraft captured this image. It shows huge plumes of smoke over North Carolina. Wildfires are reportedly burning at several locations in the mountains of the western part of the state. Drought has been blamed for fires. Burn bans have been established throughout the region. And now let's go over to Haley to hear about what's coming up in sports.
How's it going, everyone? I'm Haley Horanowicz. Ohio senior Ty Harriott plans to take his collegiate golf game to the next level after graduation. And national champions the Cleveland Cavaliers were handed a surprise last night from the Atlanta Hawks. All this and more next on Newswatch. And stay tuned to WOUB. Here's a look at what's coming up tonight on your public television station. Friday nights are all about high school football, but when the games are over and the helmets come off, it's time for some gridiron glory. I'm your host, Danny Dean, back under center. Don't miss a play this season. Join myself and the rest of our team on Friday nights at 11:30 on WOUB, and catch us again on Saturday mornings at 11:30. We are committed to bringing you the stories of players, coaches, and communities, and of course, we can't forget about some highlights. We all know there's nothing better than Friday nights and gridiron glory.
Ohio University students really have a huge sense of pride in our campus, in our school, and in our education.
People don't come to Ohio just to go to college. They come here to become a Bobcat.
It's a really unique atmosphere.
Bobcat pride is having that natural camaraderie.
Bobcats are just happy to be Bobcats.
My favorite time of year at Ohio has to be homecoming.
When the alumni come back, you can see that the love of this university doesn't fade.
Once you're a Bobcat, you're always a Bobcat.
My professors really care. They care about my grades, they care about my opportunities, they care about my experiences, they want me to succeed.
They give those opportunities to the students.
My professors have been extremely approachable.
Literally, their door is always open.
You can go to them with pretty much anything.
Everyone knows your first and your last name and where you sit in the classroom.
I really never feel like I'm being talked down to or just being taught material. I always feel like I'm having a conversation.
And they want to share those opportunities and those experiences with us.
I knew that I wanted to come to Ohio University from the very first time I visited here.
There's something about the campus that grabs you.
It was really comforting.
Very welcoming.
It's one thing to write down your name and your GPA and that kind of stuff and send it in. It's another thing entirely to be here and see how great it is.
The campus here is just electric.
Absolutely gorgeous. Everything just looked really college-like.
I looked at my mom and I said, "This is it." And she said, "The tour's just started." I said, "No, you don't understand. This is it."
Welcome back. I'm Haley Horanowicz. The Ohio University men's golf team has seen many great athletes come and go throughout the years. But it's been a long time since it's seen professional golf aspirations. Senior and co-captain Ty Harriott has decided to go pro. He plans to go back to Maryland, his home, after he graduates, and work with his swing coach to get his game where it needs to be. Ty led the team with a 71.1 scoring average this fall season. He also tied the third best three-round total in program history, shooting a 70, 65, and 72. The professional golf world isn't just a walk in the park, though. It is a difficult process. Ty will try and qualify for the Latin American Tour and the Canadian Tour. If he does well, this will move him up to the WEB.com, the preceding tour to the PGA. Ty says the next step for him will be improving his ball striking consistency, and he can't wait to make this dream a reality. Speaking of dreams, the Ohio men's hockey team just got theirs. Ohio moved up to number one today in the American Collegiate Hockey Association Division I rankings. The Bobcats came back in the third period Friday to grasp a shootout win over Michigan Dearborn. And on Saturday, they defeated them again 8-1. As the fall sports season winds down and the winter season starts up, the Ohio Athletic Department decided to bring in a speaker this Monday night. Dr. Derek Greenfield spoke to the entire Ohio student athlete body. The athletes did several bonding activities because his theory is the closer the athletes here become, the better they will perform. Greenfield has proven to help several programs succeed. Baseball pitcher Jake Rowan said it was very eye-opening for him and every other athlete. It helped them open up and become closer to each other as a whole, and he's excited to see the outcome of it. The Bobcats travel to Kent State for an intense volleyball matchup against the Golden Flashes tomorrow. Ohio and Kent State match up evenly with a 14-12 and a 14-13 record respectively, but are unable to catch up to a 21-5 record of Miami. Ohio redshirt sophomore Katie Nelson won Offensive Player of the Week and will try to keep it going for the Bobcats. Cleveland's six-game winning streak to kick off the Cavalier season came to an end last night as the Hawks squeaked by with a score of 110-106. Dennis Schroeder led the way for Atlanta with 28 points, while newly acquired center Dwight Howard led both teams with 17 rebounds. The Cavs' offense struggled early in the game, and Cleveland failed to stay undefeated. The Cavs next look to rebound on the road against the Washington Wizards on Friday. A loss to the Cubs in the World Series was an upset for the city of Cleveland, but Cleveland shortstop Francisco Lindor was able to win a Golden Glove after his first full MLB season. He was named the youngest middle infielder in team history to win a Golden Glove at the age of 22 and the youngest Tribe player since 1976. It is believed that this is just the start of this young athlete's career. The Blue Jackets will look to get into the win column tonight as they welcome the Anaheim Ducks into Nationwide Arena. Columbus goalie Sergei Bobrovsky has been solid from them so far and managed to shut out the Ducks just over a week ago. Columbus is coming off a tough overtime loss against rival St. Louis Blues and are trying to keep up a tough Metropolitan Division. I'm Haley Hrenowich, and that's it for sports. Back to you, Justin.
Thanks, Haley. Donald Trump appears to be serving quite the dessert at his election night party in New York. This victory cake was delivered Tuesday night to Trump Tower, complete with Secret Service escort. As you can see, the cake is a life-size bust of the Republican presidential nominee. The cake is already the talk of social media, with many suggesting the bust looks a bit sad and not really resembling Trump. Trump's election night party took place just around the corner from Trump Tower at the New York Hilton. Now let's go over to Allison for one last look at weather.
Thanks, Justin. Now, overnight tonight, temperatures dropping to 34 degrees as our low temperature, with decreasing clouds as we head through our nighttime hours, and calm conditions as those rain showers from earlier today move their way out. Now, tomorrow, no rain in our forecast, sunny skies throughout the day with 59 degrees as our high temperature, so nice, warm, seasonable day. Make sure you can get out there and enjoy it because cooler temperatures are on their way in. And winds southwest 5 to 10 miles per hour. And looking at your extended forecast, 59 for Thursday, then dropping to 57 for Friday. Then look overnight, that 31 degrees. Saturday, though, 50 degrees as your high temperature remains chilly overnight into Sunday with 57 degrees, 35 for Sunday night. And then by next week, it looks like it's going to begin to warm up again. So it's going to see some cooler temperatures into our evening, but it's going to warm up again, so good weather is coming in store. I'll send it back over to our anchors.
Thanks, Allison. And that does it for our broadcast this evening. Thanks for watching. I'm Justin Holbrock.
And I'm Abby Grisey. Stay tuned for the PBS NewsHour coming up next. And remember, you can find the latest news anytime at woub.org. Have a great night. Friday nights are all about high school football, but when the games are over and the helmets come off, it's time for some gridiron glory. I'm your host, Danny Dean, back under center. Don't miss a play this season. Join myself and the rest of our team on Friday nights at 11:30 on WOUB, and catch us again on Saturday mornings at 11:30. We're committed to bringing you the stories of players, coaches, and communities, and of course, we can't forget about some high